we've been working on in recent years is a project on surgeons' non-technical skills. And what non-technical skills are, is these are the thinking skills like decision making, situation awareness, and teamwork skills like communication, how teams communicate, how teams work together. What we've been doing then are what we would call a series of task analysis. We're trying to understand what are these non-technical skills that are being used while people are doing a technical task. And we've done interviews, we've done observations, we've done some survey work, we've worked with panels of surgeons. And so the project team has involved psychologists, really industrial psychologists who do this kind of work, as well as surgeons and an anaesthetist, in fact, who work together to get these data, to review them, to build up the work. And the result of the work has been a tool which we call NOTS, non-technical skills for surgeons. And this is a taxonomy, a syllabus, I might say, you could use in training, and it's also a rating tool where one surgeon can watch another surgeon operating and then give them some feedback on their performance. The rationale for the kind of work we've been doing really comes, I think, essentially from the whole movement on patient safety. So you may be aware about 10 or more years ago, it was realised that about 1 in 10 patients who go into healthcare have some kind of adverse event. Many very minor, some much more serious. And about 50% of these are preventable, and quite a lot of these will happen in the higher risk domains of healthcare, such as surgery. And the surgeons are aware of this, and we're very keen to look at techniques that were being used in other high-risk industries such as aviation, and I happen to have worked with airline pilots to develop a system like this for rating their behaviour while they're flying the plane. So we took techniques that we'd used in aviation and started to apply them in this project with surgeons. This is obviously a new tool, they're just beginning to introduce training courses, they're just beginning to put these skills into some of their training criteria, professional competence standards. So we will be able to look in future to see whether that new kind of approach to surgical training does actually have a benefit for patients at the end of the day.